So let's bring on board George Alexander, MD at Muthoot Finance. George, hi, good morning. Brokerages are very bullish in Muthoot Finance. Your company has now become the second NBFC and has delivered, or rather second best NBFC, and has delivered a 25% year-to-date return. What, according to you, are the growth trends ahead going forward, and when is it that you overtake the likes of a Bajaj Finance? George, can you hear me? Okay, we'll connect with him again. Let's just tell you what's happening in the market. Down 0.5%. All sectoral indexes, by the way, now are in the red. If I just look at the Nifty texture, while Reliance is just about staying put, 1% higher, Unilever, irrespective of the impressive performance, has given up its gains. There's ONGC holding up. There's Kotak Bank looking good. And yeah, Vedanta and Hindalco, and even Wipro actually ahead of its numbers, is holding up. Remember, there's all talk that there is going to be a bonus announcement as well in today's board meet. So that's keeping the stock abreast. But I think George is back with us. And just was wondering, George, what, according to you, are the growth trends going forward for the industry? And when is it that we have you surpass Bajaj Finance as the top NBFC?
That's a tall order. Probably every company would like to compete with the next in line. So that's a part. Muthoot Finance is doing well. The gold loan business has also started going up, and many other concerns which were there is behind us, especially the funding, the ALM, all those things are behind us now. So we should see uptick in the gold loans in the next 2-3 months. So also the other verticals also.
Right. How has been the performance in the gold loan segment, and what is the outlook going ahead?
See, the gold loan sector for the last quarter has not been good. Probably it is flat growth in the last quarter. But from December and the latter half of December, now we are seeing uptick in the gold loans. So we should see better results in this quarter. So as I was saying earlier, we should end the year with a 15-year AUM growth compared to the last year, year on year. 15 basis points. No, 15% growth in the AUM.
Right. How are your other businesses, home and microfinance, faring? What are the growth and AUM targets for both these businesses?
See, the microfinance is doing okay because it did not have any issues. But for the housing, home finance, certainly home finance sector is having some ALM issues. But because this ours is fully backed by Muthoot Finance, it doesn't have a issue with that. But overall, the home finance sector, I don't think everybody is growing aggressively. So we also have only a muted growth in the next quarter for home finance.
How do you see your revenue mix shaping up from here on?
See, as of date, we have 10% of the assets management other than gold loan. Probably we should end the year with maybe 14-15% with more than other than gold loans. So the revenue also should be the same. But of course, as far as gold loans is concerned, it gives a better revenue than both the others. But the other businesses are longer term. The housing finance is longer term. Gold loan is shorter term. But the revenue also probably it should be almost the same or little more skewed to gold loan as revenue compared to the AUM.
Right. Last time, you know, during our interaction, you said you expect the borrowing cost to increase amid growing concerns. So how are you? How are your margins looking for Q3?
See, as far as gold loans are concerned, we have seen a 100 bps rise in the incremental borrowings from banks. But for gold loan sector, it is the customers are not that interest sensitive, unlike housing finance, etc. So we have been able to pass on this to the customers. So in the last 3 months, we have raised our interest also by 100 bps. So the margins, the net interest margins, we hope should remain stable or steady as we were having earlier.
Right. So, you know, there have been growing concerns on the asset quality and the growth in the SME segment. What is your total exposure to this segment and what is the outlook going forward? Is there something to be wary of?
See, gold loans, we don't do into SMEs. It is for individual loans. The average ticket size is only 35,000 rupees. So for that, there is no impact, if at all there is, as you said, in the MSME sector. So that is not affecting our gold loan, which is 85% plus of our portfolio. The other is the housing finance and the microfinance. So we don't see any impact there also. So in NPS, etc., gold loan, whatever NPS we have, today we have about less than 2% NPA. That's also, it has never resulted in any loan losses for us. But it is just, we are giving more time to the customer to repay his gold loan. So till now, in the last several years, we have never lost 1 rupee also to because of NPA in the gold loan. So NPA is not an issue for a gold loan. But of course, it can be an issue for the housing finance or for the microfinance. But there our portfolio is around 10% plus or 10 to 12% of our total business only.
Right. Finally, what is the outlook ahead on growth and asset quality? I know you've alluded to that, but you know, I particularly want to understand your strategy with the general election approaching. The government has been pushing on populist measures. Do you think farm loan waivers are gaining popularity? And do you see that impact of such schemes coming with the company? In which light, how would you look at your projections for growth?
See, farm loan waivers, I don't know whether it is going to have any impact on gold loan customers, because gold loan customers and farm loans, we don't do farm loans, so gold loan customers it's not going to have. But people having more money with them during the election time certainly should throw up probably more consumer spending, and the economic growth also should grow if the elections are there and more money is coming into the hands of the public. So I don't think there is going to be any impact on that elections with regard to gold loans, or maybe not even the gold loan recovery also, because we have the 100% collateral with us.
George, great to have you on the show. Thank you so much for taking the time out and chatting with us.
Thank you.
Let's move forward. You've got Wipro, which is actually the same.